Glenn Beck is a radio and television host whose latest book is currently number one on the New York Times bestseller list. It's a touching novel called The Christmas Sweater, but most of it is autobiographical. Recently, I talked with Glenn about his personal story, the economy, and what lies ahead for America under a new administration. Watch this.
Millions of Americans love talk show personality Glenn Beck. His quick wit and candid opinions have made him a hit on the radio, and his popular CNN TV show moves to Fox News in January. Now, just in time for the holidays, Glenn Beck shares a story about the greatest gift in life, one that can't be bought no matter how much money you have.
This Christmas, number one New York Times bestselling author Glenn Beck presents a new holiday classic about family, faith, and most of all, forgiveness. The Christmas Sweater, in bookstores everywhere, right now.
It's so good to have you with us. Welcome.
Thank you, sir. Good to see you.
I've seen you in that conservative talk show, and I can't visualize you as a hip rock and roll DJ, but you were.
Yeah, you didn't know me back in
the old days.
Yeah. Just a totally different guy back then.
Were you a screaming rocker? I mean, you were.
Yeah, I was a hard living, hard drinking. I'm a recovering alcoholic. I did drugs most of my life. I was in the 90s. I hit bottom. I lost my family and suicidal. And doctor gave me 6 months to live, and I turned my life around.
You don't mean it.
Yeah.
You were all those things.
Oh, yeah. Yes, sir. And in 2000, I dedicated my life to the Lord, and He has been great to me. He has been so profoundly good.
Well, what a transformation. That's a miracle of God's grace.
Yeah, it is amazing. Well, it is amazing.
That's marvelous.
Thank you, sir.
This book, by the way, you wrote called Christmas Sweater. I frankly confess I haven't finished it, but you are such a talented writer. It's a moving story.
Thank you. I can't wait for you to read, especially the end, and the last chapter is called How It Begins. And it's just how at the end of things, if you really understand the real gift of Christmas, if you understand that it's all about the atonement, now everything begins.
Yeah.
And I can't wait for you to read that book.
Well, I'm going to look forward to it. It's fascinating. It's a marvelous story from the very get-go. Autobiographical or just partly so?
No, it is pretty darn close. It's probably about 90%.
You're the son of a baker?
Oh, yes.
Were you really?
Yeah. And just outside of Seattle, like a little town called Mount Vernon, Washington.
Yeah.
My dad was a baker and just an amazing man. And that last Christmas with my mom, she gave me a sweater. And a lot of the events that happened there, it was the year that I found out that I was poor, or that we were poor, growing up.
Yeah.
It's not like it is today. We didn't know if you were poor or rich. You just were.
Yeah. Yeah.
You know, and I didn't appreciate what my mother did to be able to get that sweater to me for Christmas, and it wasn't the gift that I wanted. And after that Christmas morning, I took it upstairs and I just thoughtlessly threw it on the floor, and she came in and she looked at me and she had tears in her eyes and she said, "Is that your Christmas sweater?" And it was at that point that I could see her, what she did for that sweater.
She had to knit the thing herself.
And it shouldn't have surprised me, but it did,
Mm-hmm.
She died shortly thereafter. Oh. And
you couldn't get over it.
No, and it's what took my life into another course, because then mistake after mistake started piling up on top of each other, and by the time I was 35, Pat, I couldn't find my way out. This is the story that put me down on the floor in the fetal position wanting to kill myself by the time I was 35. This is my biggest shame.
Yeah.
And now it's on nightstands all across America. And it's my biggest joy, not the book, but the journey to know that redemption isn't something that a preacher says.
It's
real.
Isn't that what God does? He takes the hard parts of our life and makes into something beautiful.
You know, I in 2000, I got baptized and I stood in the water and I was so desperate. I couldn't do it anymore. And I stood in the water and I remember almost shouting at him in my head and saying, "I can't do it anymore." And you have promised me that if I do the things you tell me to do, you will take all of this away. You cease to be God if you don't keep up your side of the bargain. And my life changed on that day. He is wonderful because he's handcuffed to his promises. It's up to you.
you put it to him. He's on record. He's got to perform.
He has to. Otherwise, he ceases to be God. Otherwise, he's not real.
It's amazing.
Yeah.
Amazing. You were doing rock and roll radio. You went into, when you were a kid, I mean, you were like 13 or 14.
And 13 years old.
13 years old. Well, this story here, you were 12?
Yeah. This is the story of the last Christmas of my mom, and then she died shortly after. In the book, it's a car accident, but in real life, she committed suicide. And then I immediately grew up, and I went to work at 13 years old and just went on that path. And it took me into some dark, dark places. And,
You know, thank God you've come out into the light. I'm so thrilled. Yeah. I'm going to shift gears just a little bit.
Sure.
You comment on the changing scene. You wrote another best-selling book that we discussed on this show about a year or so ago.
Yeah.
What's the deal? How do you see this country right now?
I think we're in real trouble. Mm-hmm. For 2 years, I've been saying on radio and television, the economy is going to fall apart at the seams. We are headed for real disaster. Mm-hmm. And it's a global thing. And nobody would listen. And I tell you, Pat, it was a real frustration because I felt a prompting to wake people. Mm-hmm. And no one would listen. And I'm happy to say that I'm sensing more and more that people are waking up. But
it may be too late.
Well, it is too late for that. But we know the ending. And I will tell you that it's time for God's people, I don't care what your faith is, to stand together. Mm-hmm. Because there is a force that is going to try to divide us as much as they can. And only divided will we fail. And we are going to be held with eternal consequences if we are the people that lose man's freedom. Mm-hmm. This is a country that was founded on divine principles. Through divine providence, we are all here. And it is time. At some point, our families are going to say, Dad, Grandpa, what was it that you found more important than freedom? How did you lose it? Mm-hmm. And we're about to lose it if we don't wake up and we don't stand together.
Yeah, if we've been worshiping the dollar, if he kills the dollar in our economy, that may be the trigger for a great spiritual revival or collapse.
I think there is going to be a huge spiritual revival, but I have to tell you, there's going to be a very, very hard time along the way getting there. I'm afraid of the possibility of fascism in this country. I'm afraid of a possible civil war. Just every scenario that you could think of is on the table, and only the Lord helping us, and only people who respect the Constitution are going to be able to save it if they just have peace in their hearts and reach out and stop hating. You know, stop the hatred. Sure. So I don't know a Democrat that I think is actually a communist that's out smoking dope trying to destroy the country. Mm-hmm. We don't know those people in our real life. We may have different policies, but our principles are the same. And we must stop believing in the cartoon characters that people create to make us hate each other.
On both sides.
On both sides.
Yeah, I've been some of those cartoons.
I know you have.
What do you think, what you're saying, how does this election play into that scenario?
You know, Rahm Emanuel said last week, he said in the Wall Street Journal, he said that you can't let a big crisis go by. And what he continued on, he said, what I mean by that is they provide opportunity to do things that you couldn't get done. Take that out of just the administration. Look at the Congress. Look at other countries. Look at Al-Qaeda. Look at Russia. There are a lot of people that would like to see us destroyed. It's something I've talked about on the air for 5 years called the perfect storm. It is finally here, and it is ashore. Now that we are so weakened, at some point, I've been saying, at some point, somebody's going to say, oh my gosh, look at this. Now, go, 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 go. Yeah. And the whole world will change in the blink of an eye. We just have to understand the times that we're living in and don't dismiss that. Get on your knees, pray, listen to the Spirit, follow the Spirit, because you need to, because quite honestly, you're not getting anything. I'm in the media. I know. Yeah. You're in the media. Yeah, you know. Absolutely. You're getting lies left and right.
Well, it's just a thrill to have you with us, and keep it up. You're now going to be on Fox, I understand.
Yes, sir. January 18th.
Fair and balanced. What are you going to be doing?
Same basic thing. I talked to the people at Fox's the other day, and the one thing that one reason why I went over there is because I just think that I needed to be with people who are fearless and saw the world a little more like I did. And the one thing that we talked about was, I'm going to do my best to tell you what others are afraid to tell you, or others just don't see in the news.
You got a time slot yet for
5 o'clock?
5 o'clock.
Yeah.
Good.
5 o'clock.
Good. You'll round up the day. Well, I'm thrilled to hear that, and you'll be there among those who are fair and balanced. I guess you're not going to replace Sean or O'Reilly.
No, I don't think so. I don't think any replacing needs to be done.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's the Christmas sweater. This is a marvelous Christmas book, and it'd be a wonderful gift to give somebody at Christmas. It's available where books are sold. Glenn Beck, we appreciate him and his outspoken stand for righteousness. Glenn, good to have you with us.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you. We'll be back with more right after this.